Those are the subdivisions. What's the time signature? 4-4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right. Cool. It's a halftime feel. All right. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right. I mean, for the most part, you've got some 16s going here on the drums. But now go ahead, try to go ahead and play the song as you hear it with the drums right in front of you. Good meats. You got the meat. You got the 1, 2, 3, 4. A 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, if you could, he's playing on the rim of the drum here, which you kind of have this like. So, if you would, all right, that's the idea. But you can still keep this here. I like what you're doing here. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Can you do something like this?
So it's like.
Bit about there, that's groovy. So we're trying to put the hi-hats on the and. Mm-hmm. 1, 2, 3, 4.
How is it?
So you can stay with this over here. Now the song's like, I'm sorry, the song's not in my head anymore. Instead of breaking everything down, like let's get the other important notes for the kick drum, and what you do is the foot pattern is going to go underneath all that stuff on top. That's going to be your practice.
Okay.
You know, but really, like I want to give you some more. Make sure you have some good fundamentals before. Floor tom off to his left side. So if you want to actually play the actual groove, you're gonna have to slide your right hand under here.
Miss it for a moment.
You're gonna have to slide your hand under here. That's why he puts it over here, because it's a little bit more accessible. It's a little crazy, all right. But let's keep it pretty simple. He's gonna have. Just try to make it. Kind of see it?
Mm-hmm. So it's like the. Okay, I'll go. So it's like the.
Wait. A little bit more. Yeah. finish off with a two.
Okay, so.
Mechanics. Remember to keep it musical, you know. So, well, this is again not exactly beat for beat for beat on this. I'd rather us just like look at it and see what it actually what he's doing. But I'm listening. I'm like, all right, cool. I hear the gist of it, but the role of it is what you want to have. You know, all right. So with that, like, I also want to give you I wanted to see like where your your freedom is, your creativity, you know. So let's play around with like a little bit of an idea of how you want to play drums for like the first group. The first, if you want to sit down and play like a nice package of drums, give a lead in, a groove, a fill, and then an out.
Okay.
All right. And in between, you have transitions, as in just like fillers, maybe a drum synth, like a cymbal, you know. Or some kind of moment, but anyhow. So, let's see. If I have these two. Okay, cool. So, a good lead in. Try just like a 16th, 16th, 8th, 16th.
So it's like 1 and a 1 and a 1 and a.
1 and a 2 and 3 and a 4 and a. That's cool. Let's try it. You create one. What was that?
Oh.
All right, so we're thinking a little straight terms. So think of it, all right, like 8, 8, 16, 8.
So what?
Cool. Make it happen, make it smooth. Let's put a little smaller one together. Let's try a 1, E, and a. Go again. 1, E, and a. 1, E, and a. Somewhere else. Let's call that your lead in. One, and up. All right. Now let's go to a groove. Let's find a remember the hip hop groove?
Is it just like the?
That's straight eights. Hip hop had at least little, you know, on beat three. You gotta lead in into a groove like that. So one E and a and two and E. You can get that far.
So.
Make that nice and smooth. Handle that, like get that far. That's a lot of movement, you know? It's like, all right, cool, chase. Jump on, hop on the kick. You know, give us a little groove. You know, that's what somebody says. And you know that you're about to step up and play, you know? Try that. 1 E and up. Smooth it out. 1 E and up. 1 2 and up. Where is it, Rocky?
Very the big. Transition between
cool.
the fifth.
Okay. Good ear, good ear. Is that your favorite one?
No.
Love one. Get one. So you wanted to speak a sentence well. That's how a drums would speak a sentence. You know, think about if you want to make it speak a sentence smoothly in drum language. Get it smooth. Alright. Pause, it's alright. You might have heard it. Put your body in there. One E and a that right hand's got to come back over to that one sooner. It's because all it is, if I asked you not to play it on these toms, and I said just play the one E on the snare, and then go ahead and do that. See how smooth that is? That was even their first run, way smoother. Make the same thing happen there. It's better. Cool, all right, so. You got that, you got a lead in and you got your groove starting. And you played it up, you played it to three. All right, play it now to four. So one and two and three and four and, cool?
Okay.
I like that groove too, that's sweet. You know, you didn't put the snare on four, you put it on and. That's cool, go ahead and do that again if you can remember. Get it smooth. Cool, you felt it on the and?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, cool. All right, so that would make one bar. The first bar begins after the lead in. Cool? Okay. You'd be like, one, two, three, da 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 da, one, two, da, two, three, da, da. All right? Mm-hmm. So your lead in is just one beat long. It's one beat long. Just a 16th note. So you're gonna click, one, two, three, four, and a two, and cool.
Okay.
And then you're gonna play four bars.
So like,
actually, play three bars. Play three bars. Question, go.
It's like, I'm kind of confused about it. So it would be like the da 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 da, and then that sequence. And then on the fourth one, would it be the sequence again, or was it like?
At that point, I want you to create a drum fill. And that would be like how you would come out of the tune.
So it would be something like.
You have to play that. You have to play that bar again. That was one bar. All right, that's one time. You got to play it again.
So would it be the same thing like over and over again?
The lead-in is just you starting on drums. That's not you playing. You don't have to repeat the lead-in. That's just the lead-in.
Okay.
If it's in the lead, that's where it stays. It doesn't come in the middle end. It's just in the lead.
Okay. So like after you finish one like go, you don't do that again, you just like continue the beat. Okay.
Play three bars of that beat.
Okay.
Alright, cool. You almost had it. Now your beat's a little different. You know, but go ahead. One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four. Four, no. One and two and three and four and one. Good. Cool. All right. Lead in and play that beat three bars. Excellent. Cool. That at that point is where a drum fill slash outro would come, you know? Gotta do 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 do. One Anna, two Anna, three Anna, four Anna. Whatever you want to do. But you have at least four beats to complete one end. Then you got to. Alright, whatever you're gonna do, but we should get interesting.
Okay.
Hurt this. Yeah. Go for it. If it doesn't fit with the feel, you know? Alright, you got that much time loose.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So
let's get you one right here. That's you playing drums. So nobody can deny you of that. You can't be denied. It's like, hey, somebody says there's drums there and you're ready to go and start playing them, boom. You can do that much. And even if it's faster, alright? That's Groove 101 playing drums. So we had to do this because like if I ask you to play drums, usually you're in your mind. You're like, I don't know what to play.
Yeah.
That is what you can play. Cool?
Okay.
Questions, Broskis?
Not really.
Man, all right, we got one more good one. All right, one more good one.
Two more.
Two more?
Yeah.
Oh, good.
Yeah, the 15th is our.
All right.
Okay.